So in the last couple of years, I did quite some different modifications. I purchased different kind of cabinets. I'm a big arcade fan. Love these cute collectible arcades from Playmanimal, for example, that more like based on the original cabinets. I purchased custom made Neo Geo bar top systems here in my own country. There is so much that you can buy. There are so many wicked ways you can play your old school arcade games. Modifying your arcade one up with some Pandora's boxes, Raspberry Pis, or just slap a PC in it and give this thing some awesome buttons. Just keep it simple and just have fun and collecting and playing some old school games with like Pac-Man and Galaga with a numbskull. You see that happy face? That was my facial expression seeing that massive expensive cabinet. Message from the future! So this is the cabinet that Daniel made. It's a fellow Dutchman who created this basically the most expensive and most wicked cabinet you can think of. I have seen a lot of modifications in the arcade community here on Facebook. But this thing basically, if you can think of a modification for a arcade machine, he basically does it. So then we're going to do more like a quick wrap up. In the future, we will make a complete full review about this cabinet that he made. I will visit him personally and just have some fun together making this awesome video for you guys, because I think this is something you just need to see. I think the main reason he made this cabinet for himself is just that he wanted to make the ultimate and the most craziest arcade machine with the technology of nowadays. Because let's be honest, there are so many ways you can modify it. For example, if you're looking at Retro Ralph's channel back at the day, he did so many cool arcade one-ups and other different modifications. But this thing does it all. And that's what we're going to do in quick wrap up and just doing to chat what he did. But okay, so let's do a quick overview of the cabin that he has made. And I can tell you that this thing is just gigantic. It's nothing compared to Arcade 1UP. Not even the cabinet I've reviewed from other stores back in the day. This is completely custom made and it is a gigantic Y-body 4-player edition. So you can play together with your friends very easily and comfortable. So the first modification he did is the LCD marquee, and basically what it does, when you're choosing different platform or game, it will swap out to a new picture. Something is very cool and very unique. So beneath the marquee we're having two speakers for mid and high and two lights to light up on the control panel. With the arcade machine itself, the control panel is just gigantic, it's massive. And what I think is pretty cool, everything you can think of, like spinners, trackball, joystick, 4-player option, everything is on it, and even including cup holders. So this is what we're going to get with the control panel. So let's do a quick overview and let's talk about what he did and what he created, because there are some unique items. So to begin with, we have the RGB trackball, more like the supreme quality that you can get, so you have the best accuracy when it comes to playing games with a trackball. Beside the RGB trackball, what I do like about it are the buttons and the light up feature. I'm a big fan of light up buttons and joysticks, and everything is light up like it should be. And that makes the thing just unique. And you can do so many cool things with it if it comes to gameplay, but also when you're booting up a game, for example, that only needs 2, 3, or 4 buttons, they can basically light up the buttons that you're going to need to play the certain game. What I think always a big bummer with Pandora's box is that we are missing out on spinner, because the spinner gives a completely new dimension, or better said, there are so many old school games that you need to play with a spinner. So he added a couple of them, pretty cool, high quality, there's going to be very much fun to play with them. So to even make it more wicked than it already is, that beside the LCD marquee, he made this tiny LCD on the display itself that gives us also a display what kind of platform that we're playing. Come on! I have never thought about something like this, so that is pretty damn wicked in my opinion. Pretty cool. That is something just not like, why? Why? Because you can. Yep. At the front of the panel, we are finding the amplifier, just a basic amplifier for volume control, treble and bass. Then we are also having extra USB connections. That is very convenient if you want to use a keyboard or you want to add a controller for a certain game to play, like a console game. Under the control panel, you can pull down the cover, because here behind the two RGB fans, we are finding the PC. And what I understand of, he uses an AMD Ryzen with a GTX 1660. So this is just a powerhouse, and this combined with Hyperspin and an 8 TB of storage. But I do find a genius solution that you can basically boot up an app or a program with the Stream Deck that he built inside his control panel, so you don't need to keyboard and mouse every single time. Very convenient and very nice. I personally find the most funny addition to this arcade cabinet that it has a mini fridge inside to hold your beer cool. Yeah, that's pretty cool. But this was more like a quick overview of his cabinet, and I'm going to visit him. I'm going to make a full review together with him. I think it's going to be a blast making this video, because I think this cabinet is the most awesome thing I have ever seen. It can't get more wicked than this. I want to thank you for watching. Consider subscribing, hit that little bell, become the Wicked family. Check out this video if you can't wait for mine. And it will be great to have you in the Wicked family. And I will see you in the next video.